Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the React Numeric Textbox component to it.
The Numeric Textbox component receives number inputs from users, offering step-by-step adjustments and valuable features like number format support, precision control, and spin buttons. In this video, you will see how to add the Numeric Textbox component to an app, with a few of its basic features: range validation, value formatting, and setting decimal precision. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the Numeric Textbox component, I type the npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-inputs -save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the React Numeric Textbox component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Inputs package. I include the Numeric Textbox component tag and set the width to 160 pixels to render the component in specific dimensions. After that, I will define the CSS styles for the Numeric Textbox component. I open the app CSS file and import the Fluent Theme CSS references. To align the component with CSS styles, I add the attributes text align and padding with custom values. I save the changes and run the application using the command npm start. Here, you can see the Numeric Textbox component is rendered without any value. But you can use spin buttons in a Numeric Textbox to set or adjust the value. Next, I will show you how to set value programmatically. To do that, I add the value property and set it to 10. See, now the Numeric Textbox is rendered with the value 10. By default, the numeric value is often increased or decreased by 1 in the Numeric Textbox. Next, I will show you how to set range validation in the Numeric Textbox so that the value specified is within a minimum and maximum range. I add the max and min properties with the values 100 and 1, respectively. Then, I add the step property and set its value to 5 so that the number values are increment by 5. You can see the Numeric Textbox with value 10 displayed in it. When I click the upward button, it increments by 5, and the value is 15. When I click the downward button, the value again changes to 10, decrementing by 5. If I type the number 102, the value changes to 100, since I set the max range value to 100. Similarly, when I set the value to 0, it automatically changes to its min value of 1. Next, let me show you how to format this value. In the Numeric Textbox tag, I add the format property and set the value to C2, which is a currency pattern with 2 decimal places. You can see the value 10 with the default currency symbol, $, with 2 decimal places when the component is out of focus. But when I type a value with decimal places, it allows me to type more than two decimal places. Let's restrict that. First, I add the property decimals and set the value to 2. Then, I add the property validate decimal on type and set its value to true. Now, I can type the value 34.54, but after that I cannot type any numbers. Since the value is set to 2 in the decimals property, and the validate decimal on type property is set to true, the numeric text box does not allow me to type more than 2 decimals. Next, let me show you how to give this value custom format. The numeric text box supports 2 custom specifiers, hash and zero. First, I'll use hash to format the value. In the format property, I remove the value C2 and add a value with hash as a string. Here, I have added a value with 3 numbers in the integral part and 2 in the fractional part. As you can see, the value 10 is displayed. When I add a fractional part to the value 10, it shows the fractional part. When hash is used, it displays the decimal values only when needed. To show the decimal values always, I have to use 0 in the format string. For that, I remove the hash value and add a value with 0. I have added 3 numbers in the integral part and 2 numbers in the fractional part. Now, you can see the value 10 is displayed along with 0 in its integral part and 2 fractional numbers even when there are no decimal values specified. Finally, I will show you how to hide the spin buttons in the numeric text box. I just add the show spin button property and set its value to false. You can see the numeric text box renders without the spin buttons. In this video, I have shown you how to add the numeric text box component to a React application. I also shown you range validation, value formatting, and setting decimal precision. If you would like to see the working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.